One of the descriptive terms that often gets thrown around when talking about landscape photography is the term moody. I don't think a lot of people really understand what it is that they're identifying as moody in an image. And in this video, I wanted to talk a little bit about how I inject mood and emotion into my photos. When it comes to mood, there are three main creative tools that I use to convey a particular emotion: saturation, white balance choice, and the overall brightness of an image. One of the reasons that we shoot raw is so we can make a lot of these creative decisions after the fact. Generally speaking, a warm color temperature is going to convey a feeling of, well, obviously warmth, but it's also going to convey a feeling of happiness. And the reverse is true with a cold color temperature. So a lot of times, if I'm trying to convey a sad or quote unquote moody image, I often go with a colder color temperature, which will give the photo a bit more of a dreary, sad feeling. And if I'm trying to convey a warm, happy, sunny day, a lot of times I will go with a warmer color temperature. A similar thing is true for saturation, but it's a little bit more complex than that. A saturated image feels very vibrant, it feels very full of life. A desaturated image feels very dreary and absent of life. But you also have control over which colors are saturated. And one of the things that I always encourage people to do is to really take control over the saturation of each individual color. You can do that in the HSL panel in Lightroom or in Adobe Camera Raw. By controlling the saturation of every color individually, you have control over which colors are going to be dominant, and you can make sure that your color palette reflects the feeling and the emotion that you want your photo to have. Again, getting back to the happy versus sad feeling, if the blue tones are dominant, it's going to convey a little bit more of a sad feeling to the photo. Lastly, luminance has a massive impact on the feeling of a photo. Again, speaking in general terms, a really bright photo is going to just convey a feeling of happiness and hope, but a dark photo feels dark and dreary. These are all ways that post-processing has a really massive impact on the feeling and the emotion of a shot. Yes, you can control some of this stuff at the time of capture, but to really fine-tune and to hone these things, you need to be shooting in RAW and you need to be taking creative control over all of these decisions later on when you go to post-process the image. So for all of these reasons, these are why I encourage everybody to not only shoot RAW, but to take post-processing seriously, because this is where, in my opinion, 50% of the creative process comes back into a photo. This is where we're able to inject feeling, emotion, and mood into our photographs.